Hi, I'm Daphne Richards. Our question this week is on photosynthesis and how plants respond to shade versus sun, a topic that I am, being a horticultural geek, very excited to discuss. As I'm sure you know, plants perform photosynthesis via chlorophyll, and I'm sure you also know that chlorophyll is green, giving leaves their characteristic green color. But have you ever noticed that plants that are happier in shade are usually darker green than plants that thrive in sun? That's because the more chlorophyll a plant has in its leaves, the darker green it will be. Shade plants, often native to tropical regions where they grow as understory plants, need quite a bit more chlorophyll to produce a sufficient amount of sugars to feed themselves and grow, while plants that grow in full sun don't need much chlorophyll at all by comparison, since sun is plentiful, so they tend to be lighter green overall. While this isn't a hard and fast rule, it is pretty common. For example, compare a corn plant with its yellow-green leaves to a hosta or a cast iron plant. The difference in green is striking. Shade plants also don't flower as much as plants that prefer full sun, or their flowers are less significant, since sufficient sunlight's necessary to produce showy flowers. A sun plant, when placed in a shady spot, will often not flower and may be lanky and unattractive, since it will try to stretch up in search of sunlight. Variegation is also common in shade plants. Those white striped areas on variegated leaves lack chlorophyll, and colors other than green are also more common in shade plants, indicating a different strategy altogether, where the plant may have replaced much of the chlorophyll with carotenoids and anthocyanins, giving them orange or purple characteristics. Our plant this week is Sable Mexicana, known commonly as Texas Palmetto, among many other common names. These palm trees are native to the Rio Grande Valley in extreme southern Texas, near the Gulf of Mexico. They're normally available in quite small containers, but don't let their size in the nursery fool you. These stout-trunked palms get up to 50 feet tall in their native habitat. The larger they are when purchased, the more expensive they'll be, since growth is very slow. The larger the specimen, the older it is, and the more time and effort the grower has invested in it. Because of this, most palms are sold according to caliper inch, rather than container size. Although palms aren't generally planted for their flowers, once mature, Texas Palmetto does produce creamy white flowers in spring on stalks that may jut 7 to 8 feet above the top of the plant. This is noteworthy since birds are attracted to them and to the black berry-like fruit produced afterward. As with other palms, Texas Palmettos are evergreen and very adaptable to different soil types. They're fairly xeric, but since these palms are native to a warm, humid, relatively rainy region, they do need a bit of water to stay healthy. Listed as hardy only to Zone 8, an unseasonably harsh winter may lead to the demise of this tree, so be sure to plant on the southwest side of your home, which is warmest, and be prepared to protect this tree during an especially harsh cold snap. Our viewer pick this week comes via Facebook from Diana Saunders. She captured this video with her iPhone of a zebra long-winged butterfly laying eggs on a passion vine in September. Thanks, Diana. We'd love to hear from you, so head on over to klru.org/ctg to send us your questions, photos, or video from your garden.